Hi, everyone. Yes, I will talk about CSS counters, but not the usual parts of them. There are a lot of stuff I would talk if this was a longer talk, but I would talk about three aspects that I find the most interesting. And at first, one warning. I would talk about some really experimental code, and don't try to reproduce this in production and use this for your sites, because there are really, really hard problems with accessibility. And yeah, experiments are great, but you should experiment responsibly and don't experiment in production. The first thing I would talk about is how counters are rendered. Basically, you may know that counters are used for ordered lists. And you can actually change how they're rendered using some symbols that are not numbers. And you actually can render them as some words. How this happens is that we can actually have some really big numbers as their values. And if they would be alphanumeric, then, alphabetical, then they would actually render as words. Why this happens is this because a word is actually a number, but in a numeral system with the base 26. So when we convert it into the decimal system, we can use it for a counter, and then it would be just something. And we can use this for some other experiments like this one. This is a keyboard, a virtual keyboard, which is implemented in HTML and CSS only. And you can write something here, and it would be stored as a counters, each letter a counter, and we can use it somewhere. And yeah. Another aspect of counters is really unique for them. And this is something that other CSS properties can do. It's that they are inherited through the tree, not only from the parents, but from the previous siblings. So if you have some count, some element, it would give all its counters to the next item after it. And it would also inherit the already changed number from this element, because it would be otherwise it wouldn't work for lists and for other stuff. But this is really crucial, and I use it a lot in my experiments. And the last aspect of counters is that how they affect layout. Basically, the layout can be affected by counters only in one way, in content inside pseudo elements. We can't use counters for calculations or stuff like that, at least yet. But we can output them as text. And when we output them, they can have different number of symbols and stuff like that. And we can really use this alongside some other really complex stuff like flexbox and wrapping, and have, for example, like this. We can have two elements with two counters, and they would affect some other block. And we can show or hide some content based on those counters, and maybe even some conditions with them. This is, I wrote an article about this, and another example in this article is this game of Gomoku, or Five in a Row, which you can play with some friends, and this is implemented also using counters and without any JavaScript. And basically, counters can be used in a lot of places, but yeah, maybe not in productions, because there are a lot of other ways to make games and make keyboards. That's all. Thank you. Experiment responsibly.